Hello, my name is Aaron. This tutorial shows how to customize the ribbon in Microsoft Word. The ribbon is the main toolbar at the top of the screen that's divided into tabs. Within the tabs, commands are organized into related groups. First, we'll customize the ribbon by moving, adding, and removing tabs and groups. Next, we'll add commands to the ribbon. Then we'll return the ribbon to its default settings. Plus, the bonus section at the end shows how to collapse and reopen the ribbon. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to the recent single purchase versions of the software. These steps don't apply to Word for the web. We'll cover this topic in Word for Mac in a separate tutorial. To begin, right-click a blank area in the ribbon, and then select Customize the Ribbon from the shortcut menu. When the Word Options dialog box appears, select an option from the Customize the Ribbon menu. The main tabs are the tabs that appear when you open Word. This will be the best option for most users. All tabs are all the tabs available, including those that appear when Word is operating in compatibility mode. Tool tabs are the contextual tabs that appear at specific times, such as the Picture Format tab that only appears when a picture is selected. Next, select the arrow next to the tab if you want to see the groups within the tab. You can also select the arrow next to the group to show the commands within that group. You can now select the tab or group that you want to customize. It's not possible to customize the preset commands individually. Once you've made your selection, use the Move Up or Move Down arrows to change the position in the ribbon. Typically, Move Up will move the tab or group to the left, and Move Down will move the tab or group to the right. Alternatively, select and drag tabs or groups up or down to change positions. Note that groups can be moved into different tabs. If you want to add or remove a tab, check or uncheck the box next to the name. If you want to remove a group, select it, and then select the Remove button. Individual commands can't be added or removed from the preset groups. However, they can be added to custom groups, which you can add to a new custom tab or an existing tab. To create a custom group in a custom tab, select the New Tab button. And then select the new tab, which will be labeled New Tab Custom, and select the Rename button. Next, enter a name into the Rename dialog box and select the OK button. Now select the new group that will appear automatically and then select the Rename button. When the Rename dialog box appears, you can give your group a new name. You may notice that there's an option to choose a symbol for your new group. That feature has proven problematic on my end, so I'm not going to do that today. Finally, select the OK button. If you want to create a custom group in an existing tab, select the tab, followed by the New Group button. Select the new group, and then select the Rename button. Once again, type a name into the Rename dialog box, and then select the OK button. To add commands to your new custom group, select it, and then select an option from the Choose Commands From menu. The Popular Commands and All Commands options will be the best choice for most users. From there, you can choose a command, and then select the Add button. Repeat that process until you've added all the commands you need in the group. To remove a command, select it in the group, and then select the Remove button. When you're finished customizing the ribbon, select the OK button. Your ribbon customization should appear immediately, and after saving your document should remain in effect when you open Word in the future. If you want to return your ribbon to its default settings later on, right-click a blank area in the ribbon, and then select Customize the Ribbon. When the Word Options dialog box appears, you can select a specific tab if you only want to reset that tab, and then select the Reset button, followed by Reset Only Selected Ribbon tab from the drop-down menu, or select Reset All Customizations to reset the entire ribbon. If you selected Reset All Customizations, select the Yes button in the dialog box, and then select the OK button. There are several ways to collapse or hide the ribbon. However, one of the easiest ways is to double-click on any of the tabs other than File. Once the ribbon is collapsed, you can then double-click on any of the tabs other than File to reopen it. You can also use the keyboard shortcut Control plus F1 to collapse and open the ribbon. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on my website at aaronwrightwriting.com, which is linked in the description box below, along with my playlist, How to Use Microsoft Word, where you'll find many related tutorials, including how to change the default font in Microsoft Word. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.